Howdy, RC pilots. Today, I'm going to show you how you too can fly from the cockpit of an RC fighter jet using head tracking FPV in a few steps. But before that, let me share a beautiful aerobatic flight surfing above a fog layer in a Freewing Zeus sport jet to get you motivated. Let's do it.
Controls check. Right, left.
It's important to go through a thorough checklist, just like flying a full-scale airplane. Given the amount of money and time invested to fit each FPV system, it's well worth the effort.
I guess it's better to take off to the left side.
From right to left.
Yeah, right to left, because the sun is right in my face right now.
Yep.
Okay.
And I don't blow any further than that line that you just passed.
Okay.
So there's gravel and
weeds. Thank you.
Yeah,
good to know.
I don't blow all that way down.
Thank you. All right.
Too long and people
check. Reverse throw. Check. Okay. Otherwise, it rolls forever.
Yeah.
Okay. Taking off.
You're fine. Nobody else. You got the whole field.
Rotate gears up.
Beautiful.
Flaps up. Okay. And turning. We have a little bit of fog, so I'm fog surfing a little. Wow, it's beautiful up here. I'm skimming on top. So I'm going to do a slow roll here. Oh, it's a bit fast. Oh, I should turn the rates down. I think I have full rates right now. I'm turning to half. I'm going to come back in here and set up for a loop. Try to do it as big as I can do it.
Okay, I can't see because of the sun.
Powering up now. Okay, at the OCMA pull.
You're over the actually you're over the parking area.
Sorry. Correcting.
That's okay.
Okay, barrel roll to the right. Okay. Wow, I can see the rainbow. It's amazing. Okay, I'm gonna do a slow roll here. Whoa. My reflector side just got all condensation on it. Okay, half Cuban.
Again, you're on the
Sorry, my bad.
It's all right. Just letting you know. I wouldn't care if Dave's not here.
Knife edge. Inverted. Knife edge. That's a 4-point. Not very clean, but I'll take it.
That's better.
A barrel roll, big one, coming in. Aiming at OCMA. Circling the sun. Threatening the needle. Well, I don't want to go that low. Inverted. Let me know if it's level.
Yeah, it's good.
1 minute.
I mean, it wants to go down, so you got to keep pushing it.
Yeah.
So you're a little nose heavy, I think.
Let's do that pattern test where I go up 45 and see how fast it drops. So up 45 degrees, that's 45 inverted, 1001, 1002, 1003. That's about right.
Yeah.
It dropped below horizon, so it's a little bit more nose heavy than typical pattern planes. So let me see if I could, a little slower, I mean lower rates even, if I could do a 8-point. Okay, start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There we are, 8-point roll.
Nice.
Not level, but it's like on a curve. Okay, so I'm going to do a little fog surfing here. Yeah, it's beautiful skimming on top of the fog, breaking down. And threaten the needle between the trees. A little low level. Let's see. I think I need to land pretty soon. Okay, low pass.
Beautiful.
Not super fast. I'm just holding level.
Beautiful though.
Okay, landing.
You're gonna land? Why don't you do a flyby? Check the gear.
Okay. So.
Zero.
Do a dirty pass.
I don't think I have the feel for it. I think it's dying.
Okay. We just put the gear down now. It's down. You got all four. L3.
Okay.
You're good.
I'm going to land from the west side.
From the left side?
From the left side.
The sun? Okay.
Yeah, I checked it. I can still see. I get a little better approach this way.
Okay.
It's longer. So gear's down. Full rates.
Flaps.
Flaps half. A little high. Start my turn. Full flaps, gear down, full flaps, full rates, full flare. Okay, that's a good glide slope coming in. A little power.
20 feet.
A little power.
10, 5,
flare.
3, 2, 1, you're down.
Ooh. Ooh.
That was all right.
Now, as promised, I will show you how to get in the cockpit of the RC jet plane using head tracking FPV in a few steps. First step is to make sure you have the necessary RC plane, equipment, and experience to get started. You will need at least two spare channels on both transmitter and receiver to accommodate the pan and tilt gimbal, and preferably another spare channel to switch power on and off to the air unit. So if you typically fly a 6-channel plane, you will need at least an 8-channel radio. But really, you need like a 10-channel radio, because if you have a thrust reverse or, say, separate steering, you need to accommodate those too. So with the most recent Spectron firmware update, the NX8 radio is sufficient with the expanded channel count. Also, you will want to put the system in a decently sized plane. I'd say at least a minimum of 40-inch wingspan or 1-meter wingspan, to not only be able to carry the weight, but also with flight behavior that feels more realistic. You know, like flying a real plane. The bigger the plane, the better the experience. You will also need to have intermediate level RC flying and building experience for best chance of success. I would not recommend this to an RC beginner pilot to start out with FPV. This is really for someone that's really comfortable flying every one of his RC planes, and maybe getting a little bored and want to try something new. Oops, this video is running too long. Please see the part 2 video for the rest of the steps to get you flying from the cockpit of an RC plane.